Hey guys, today we have this beautiful 2009 BMW M3 and we're going to be putting an aftermarket camera into it. Today's product we're using from NAV-TV, and this is their smart interface. This product is designed specifically for the BMW in order for us to hook up an aftermarket camera. For this install, we're using a standard basic camera that does the job and is very reliable, and we got all this power from Vision's electronics. The M3 is a beautiful, intuitive sport coupe. It does have a factory screen with navigation, but however, they did not equip it back in 2009 with a backup camera. So today we're going to retrofit it so that we can add one in. Now you might be saying the M3 is not a very large vehicle, and also with that hood bulge in the front, it's easy to park going forwards. However, this is a hard top convertible, and because of the large C-pillars in the back and the rake of the rear window, it's not the easiest thing to back up and look behind. Probably one of the hardest things about doing a backup camera install besides running it is finding a home for the camera. A lot of vehicles will have a license plate on the trunk lid or on the rear bumper, and that's where we like to go a lot of times because we have there's some sort of license plate light where we can fish the wire through because there's already wiring running through there. However, on this vehicle, because it's a hard top convertible, that trunk not only opens up forwards going towards the front of the vehicle, it opens backwards as well to allow the top to come into the trunk. And you can see here we have their factory wiring. We could put the camera in here, but I just don't like the idea of it because that wiring's moving quite a bit. I would rather have my wiring not move if I can help it. Discussing with the customer, I don't want to put it in the bumper. The customer mentioned it could have been a suggestion. The problem is if the camera ever goes faulty and we have to change it, the diameter might change and then we have a hole in the bumper. However, down low here, we have a little grill system and we can just feed the camera in here. And that way, if you ever have to change it, it doesn't really matter. We just made this hole, you can see all our filings that we have to clean up, but we don't just leave the hole bare metal. We do clear coat it, get rid of any burrs. See, this is burr we have to get rid of. And then we also add a snap grommet in so it doesn't chafe. Afterwards, we'll add some sound deadening to help hold the wire in place and also seal this hole. We now have sound deadening over the wiring to help hold it in place and also seal the hole. Let's see here, on our connectors, we add shrink tube to help seal it and hold it together, and everything's Tesla taped. In order to interface with the factory screen, we did have to pull out a lot of the dash and reroute some of the cables to go back up top here where the factory screen is. We now have our camera mounted and it's very discreet, but at the same time, if you ever need to change it, we're not wrecking the bumper doing so.
Go ahead and test this thing.
Works great. So you can see in this application, we already have a nice screen and we have factory navigation. So there's no point of trying to overhaul the whole car. But all I needed was just a backup camera add-on. Well guys, hope you learned something new, seeing that you can maintain your factory screen and add on an aftermarket camera. That way you can keep your older car and give it some newer updates. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram, Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.